With an African Union summit set to kick off this weekend, a delegation from Cote d'Ivoire allied to President Laurent Gbagbo has been in the country with a mission to lobby Kenya to support Gbagbo.
The president there is not a criminal, but the real criminals are the ones being covered by the international community and France.
The AU has, however, taken a stand and considers Gbagbo an illegitimate president. Instead, his rival, Allasane Outtara, is recognized as the lawfully elected president of Cote d'Ivoire, a position this delegation disagrees with.
The Electoral Commission's answer, gives the provisional results that are to be finally validated by the Constitutional Council. This is what happened in the country.
The three delegates are all advisors to President Gbagbo, with Williams Ateby doubling up as an MP. They were hoping to meet Kenya's foreign affairs and information ministers, as well as the president, besides human rights groups and the media. But so far, they haven't secured any appointment with any government official. On Friday, they will depart for Addis Ababa to attend the AU summit.
It is not necessarily the military solution that will be the definite or final solution. Gbagbo Laurent, the president of Gbagbo Laurent, is the president-elect of the country.
Their visit has, however, been met with indifference, with suspicion that they may be Gbagbo's emissaries intending to discredit Prime Minister Raila Odinga's mediation efforts in the troubled nation.
Certainly they're not my visitors, but I was appointed as an envoy by the African Union.
Prime Minister Raila Odinga was not at all rejected by the Ivorian nation or the government.
Gbagbo gave new assurances last Tuesday that he was open to talks over the tussle of the Ivory Coast presidency. Sylvia Chebet, Citizen Live at 9.